This is the book of Proverbs, chapter 28. We'll start at verse 15. As a roaring lion and a raging bear, so is a wicked ruler over the people. So like it over the poor people. Verse 16, the prince that one of understanding is also a great oppressor. But he that hateth covetousness shall prolong his days. I want to start off by giving all praises, all honor, all glory to called Loyam La Yahweh, Ba'ashem Yahushai, Ba'ashem Rachak, with the Fukatam, double honor to the apostles and to the elders of Great Millstone who do rule well. Peace and salutations to the Akim across the four corners of the earth, pushing his truth with faith and with sincerity, as well as risking their lives and their freedom to do so, now more so than ever. Shalom to the Akwath and the Akim out there listening and learning. Lord willingly, this was an edifying video, or this be an edifying video. Shalom to the Israelite foreigners scattered abroad in the land of the other nations, appearing like the other nations, but subscribing to this truth. To you, I'll say shalom. It's the brother Yahweh out of the GMS Cleveland Church, a fellow servant, coming at you with another lesson through the Spirit and through the power of Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahushai. And basically, I came across an article, I think it was on YouTube, you know how they post. And through that posting, it made me, the Spirit, you know, fed me with some scriptures. So, plus it's relevant information. But before I bring out the article, you know, I brought out the Proverbs 28 because it talks about how a wicked ruler basically is like a raging bear or a roaring lion, you know what I mean, oppressing the people. And with this latest, now it's not proven, but I could see it being proven. I could see it being true, rather. See it being proven and being true because, you know, the one thing that these devils can't do is basically they can't completely cover up the truth. It tells you in the book of Luke chapter 12 about all things that are hidden shall be revealed, roughly paraphrased. So, you know, although they bought up all the media and they feed you what they want to feed you, see how the Lord still is working on the right hand side, feeding or bringing out the truth. So, it says the prince that one of understanding also a great oppressor. So we're going to go into this word one of, and I believe it means lack, but lacking, right? So this is the Hebrew word.
Strong's H 2638, chaseah,
and it means in need of, lacking, needy, and want of. So the king, so like it says, the prince that one of or lacking understanding is also a great oppressor. And this prince, we're talking about these red Hebrew Edomites that's in rulership, they're lacking the understanding of the scriptures, you know what I mean? Like, at the end of the day, they set up, they lacking basically what it is to be an upright ruler, because they were set up to be, you know, the devil, or, you know what I mean? Like, the, you know, Satan on the planet, in the physical, you know, like, because, you know, their father is on the spiritual, you know, demon Satan. So, you know, on the physical, like, the father, Abba Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahushai, is our father, you know, and we set up on the right hand side, we're the spiritual children of our father. You know, these red Hebrew Edomites are the spiritual children of their father, Dayton, the devil, Salakia. So they lack in what it is to be upright, you know what I mean? It tells you in the scriptures that what the Most High made crook, who can make straight, you know. So, you know, at the end of the day, at the end of the day, you know, people, that's a hard pill to swallow, but it's just the truth. You know, like, go back to like how you got certain people that's just set up to not get it. You know what I mean? Set up, whereas 2/3 of our people are going to be destroyed. You know, the elder Menachem Zagba did a video. I didn't even know he did a video prior, but I saw it this morning. And I put it in a group chat. I don't know how many people actually watched it, but it was some very wicked thing. And, you know, and this ain't even coming from Esau Edom. This coming from Jake. Apostle Hart did a response to it, so funny, the elder apostle, because he was like, you know, thank God for Esau, and he laughed at it. But the truth of the matter is, it's some shit that Esau Edom ain't gonna do, and Jacob just, you know, now, you know, I could say my two cents on it, as far as, because they keep saying the parents, I don't think both parents is involved with that, because even a wicked ass nigga woman ain't gonna do certain shit. Just like the wickedest niggas don't do certain shit. But it's actually individual got their baby tatted. and they talking about that it's fake and all that. You can clearly see this baby getting tatted and crying. But not to digress, you know what I mean? Like, it just, this, and that's how you know this is that wicked ass generation and this shit is over with. I mean, I've seen a lot of things in my time. I've never seen that until today. So I have. But let's stay on topic. Because that's something, a conversation to talk about, but that's, you know, inconsequential. I ain't gonna say inconsequential because it's showing you the state of our people, how destroyed they are. But what these Red Hebrew Edomites, this is what's about to show you that this man is truly the devil. Let me get this though, because I was holding Daniel. So before I lose my train of thought, let me go back to that. And then bring out some of the article, Baba Salakia. Okay, so this is it says trending politics. Now there are whispers in DC that Biden is about to issue blank cause YouTube gonna do something gangster, I can already tell. Like, they ain't been flagging shit lately. Like, they probably just gonna take away whole channels. Issue Maxine passport. It says that Biden is about to issue blank passport blank for interstate travel. And it's by Kyle Becker. And I can believe it because this isn't the first time I've heard something like this. And then also, this is going to go hand in hand because they want to actually make you pay a tax to actually drive the interstate. That's the spirit. The notification had to chime with it. But nonetheless, these devils got some. So you about to go back to that system of, like I said, you know, you paying the king or the ruler for everything. You know, I forgot how what it's called, feudalism or for something like that, feudalism. You know, like when the Japanese, when you had the shoguns and whatnot, you know, America have it. I mean, you know, England had it with the kings and whatnot. Can't say America really had it, you know. But, I mean, it's a form of it when you pay taxes to your government. You know. Because in actuality, citizens is not supposed to be taxed. That was in the law. They changed the law to be able to tax the citizen. Just like these stupid-ass women that think that America's all equal for them. They only allow women to work so they can tax the household, the whole household, not just the man. Why take one income when you could get them both? So it says the Biden administration is poised to make its next unconstitutional power grab. And that's how you know, something about to happen because everybody is making it known. Even the different medias is like, it's unconstitutional. This is not constitutional. But again, I keep on trying to explain to certain people. I just was recently locked up. They're not following the Constitution anymore. That's how you know this place is over with. You know? Just based on the fact, like I said, you have a certain amount of time to be tried and convicted of whatever crime you're being charged with. They're talking about they're no longer going by that. So if they're no longer going by that, and that's somewhere in the Constitution, then they're no longer following the Constitution. In the former, it said power grab, in the former of a blank for interstate travel within the United States, according to reports on Capitol Hill. Congressional Republican lawmakers are attempting to get ahead of the forthcoming expected decree by introducing legislation to block executive order or directive. And as much as, like, and back in the day, they used to have checks and balances within the government. So one branch wasn't stronger than the other. But I've noticed lately, I don't know how they do it or what's exactly going on. I just know this, that I remember Trump went bypass Congress to pass certain things. Remember, Trump bypassed the stimulus when Congress wouldn't vote it in. So, you know, again, like you say, it is all smoke and mirrors to a certain extent. That's why certain branches of the government are exempt from actually having to take this, this venom, you know. It says in a Wednesday speech on the Senate floor, Senator Rick Scott, joined by Senators Ron Johnson and Mike Lee, introduced legislation that will bar the Biden administration from implementing said passports requirements for interstate travel, the Epoch Times reported. That's supposed to be a newspaper that literally supposed to talk about a lot of the stuff that's going on that mainstream media doesn't speak on. But you gotta remember, like I said, I think that's like the Israeli paper as well. But like I said, at the end of the day, a lot of that probably propaganda as well. I remember seeing them advertising it, and basically they kept on like pointing at, they point at basically, they'll bring out stories like that. They'll point at Russia about this or China about that. Like they was talking about how the virus really came from Wuhan, you know, certain articles like that. Where you got other newspapers and other news sources that say the virus came from America. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, smoke and mirrors. The Prevent Unconstitutional blank blank for Interstate Commerce Act would prohibit several federal agencies involved in interstate commerce and travel from requiring proof of vaccination. The Department of Transport. But see, and that's, this is like the most high lightweight fucking with people, because at the end of the day, just like how you had it where you had people basically, how they mandated it in New York that you got to take this shit, and then basically you had enough people basically bucking up to it that they had a judge send it to like a 3-judge panel to try and overturn it or whatever, and then they ruled it basically that you got to take it or be out the job. So, you know, what do you think is going to happen with this? And that's a way for them to actually lock down the cities and control who's traveling, you know? I was telling somebody recently about that, you know, it's nothing new. That's why brothers say they do nothing new, you know? Certain things that they do have been tried and tested and worked. So, you know, they say, if it's not broke, why fix it? You know, if it's going to work, you know? People, so, you know, that's why it's such a of import to actually, you know, follow history, you know, because you can't know where you're going if you ain't, you know, you don't know where you've been. If you don't know where you come from, how you gonna know where you're supposed to end up? It says, I'm gonna start over. The Prevent Unconstitutional blank blank for Interstate Commerce Act would prohibit several federal agencies involved in interstate commerce and travel from requiring proof of blank. The Department of Transportation, which oversees the Federal Aviation Administration. Ooh, that's a lot of governmental agencies, because, you know, at the end of the day, these agencies got to be approved by the government to actually function. How do you think, I just came across this information, how do you think Biden snuck this in with the whole everybody got to be vaccinated to work? Because he went through OSHA. And OSHA is a government agency that approves safe working environments. Right. Now, mind you, why do you think so many truckers are actually quitting and protesting and actually rioting? And what did they do in Australia? The Australians was fucking police up. And what did they do? They start fucking them Australians up. So, you know what I mean? At the end of the day, this is coming no matter. You people still trying to go based on the laws of this fucked up ass place. You know what I mean? Or they can't do that. They show you what they can do. They just made you sit in the fucking house. At the end of the day, they told you to sit in the house. They didn't enforce you sitting in the house. But this time, they're going to enforce it. It says, why you think all those truckers, like I said, standing up like that? And they made their ass sit down. You don't think that's coming here? They slowly showing you by doing it in New York, doing it in California, these main gigantic states where they're looked at it by all these other states. And then it's going to trickle down to each other state. It says, which oversee the Federal Aviation Administration, the National Railroad Passenger Corporation, Amtrak, the Surface Transportation Board, the Transportation Security Administration, the National Transportation Safety Board, the Federal Maritime Commission, and the Department of Commerce, according to the report. The federal government has no business imposing, blah, blah, blah. The Supreme Court has already ruled that you cannot be forced to purchase insurance under the Commerce Clause. Why would President Biden think he could do so with a mandate? Travel is critical to getting our economy fully reopened. But if this is being taken place in other countries, see, the thing is this, though. See, yeah, ooh, these Americans going to be feeling, these Babylonians going to be mad when they find out, oh, you ain't free. Salakia for that made me laugh. But point is, yeah, so what's going on? Because I just read something recently they was talking about, I think you got, oh, that's what it was. It was the airlines. You know, you had, like, he said pretty much every major airline has agreed to the mandates except for two. But then you got, I forgot what airline, basically, they did a mass firing, and now this time they're not going to do a mass firing. They're just going to lay these people off. Because you got several people that actually went and filed, you know, lawsuits against the government and everything. So how do you think the government's gonna react to that? The government don't give a fuck. You know what I'm saying? Like, the government can have you. You know, you ever see that movie, The People versus Larry Flynn? You know, his court case was going on for years. You know, the fucking government. That's just like, for instance, when you locked up or something, you file a grievance against the institution you locked up with. You think they give a fuck like that? And they could be dead wrong. You know how much you gotta know how much the Most High gotta be with you for that actually be exposed and you literally get compensated? I mean, people get killed and beaten, fucked up in jail. So lock you. These people just, I'm gonna read this part. Travel is critical to getting our economy fully reopened. Travel is travel is critical, and that's why they attacking the travel. Right. You know how much control you got over somebody if you that you can't go? That's like a hostage. You know, these motherfuckers are kidnapped. Like, Americans are sick and tired of the government telling them what to do. And then they egged it. For me, that sounds like they egged it. Or like the media involved in this shit. Because people are simple. That's why brothers got to make disclaimers when they say something. Like, they might bring out a scripture and then they may say something, and then they got to say, well, don't do that literally. Because you'd be surprised. You know what I mean? People like that scripture that talks about it's better to enter the kingdom with if the eye offend thee, pluck it out. And it doesn't literally mean pluck out your eye, but you know how many people have done that? Literally, it's literally people that's literally done that. It means to basically offend less, stop offending. You know what I mean? It don't mean literally cut, you know. But anyhow, so there have been numerous signs in recent weeks that the Biden administration is poised to issue. Oh, this is what we want. There have been numerous signs in recent weeks that the Biden administration is poised to issue a blank for interstate travel, even though it will be blatantly constitutional. See, and that, this is what's funny to me as well. These, like, the web, when you read the news off the web, it's always some kind of, like, misspelling or, they, you know what I mean? It doesn't, you know, I don't know why that is, you know, at least printed, like, newspapers. I guess because they got editors that proofread them. I don't know. Dr. Anthony Fauci, chief of the NIAID, is typically the messenger that, right. So whatever they're giving him, he's willing to take all the ridicule, and, you know, you got to sit up there and ask him. That's why he's looking stupid now, contradicting himself. He got to the point where he's like, I don't give a fuck. You ain't going to do nothing to me. He's like, bold as a lion and shit. Sure. Anyway, he says, Dr. Anthony Fauci, chief of the NIAID, is typically the messenger that the administration sends out to prime the public for forthcoming extreme measures. Fauci recently supported a blank for interstate travel. I will support that if you want to get on a plane and travel, then you should be. And why wouldn't he? Because you got to remember, this is the same man during the holidays when he said, well, yeah, I suggest you don't travel and yada, yada, yada. I suggest you don't have so many family members in the household when you have your holiday and all this old shit. So do you people realize that if they telling you how many people to have in your house, that means that they feel they have the authority to come and check to make sure that you're complying with that. Fauci later clarified to say that the Biden administration is not extending its blank to travel just yet, although it's under consideration. That's the point. So I thought of a few different scriptures. Salakia. The main one I thought of was, I don't know why I'm doing that. It's Second Ezra's chapter 2. I mean, Salaki. Second Ezra chapter 15, verse starting at verse 14. Woe to the world that them Salaki, woe to the world and them that dwell therein. Woe meaning destruction. Verse 15, for the sword and the destruction draw nigh, and one people shall stand up to fight against another, and swords in their hands. So that's going to be one nation of people fighting against another. You're going to have one group of people. You're going to have these people that feel they don't have to take this venom, as well as those that feel you have to. You're going to have people that's for the love of Babylon, and those that, you know, basically are paid to protect the laws of Babylon, and, you know, so and so forth. You know, I was just watching a video. I'm not sure if he's an elder or whatnot, but his channel is Amawan Abad, and he literally did a video, and it was an old Edomite, where he appeared like it. Well, I didn't get nothing of the spirit from him, but and basically, like, he was talking about fighting carnally, so that is an Edomite all day. Long story short, bald head, I think, like I said, but he talked about weapons, and but basically, you can tell this guy was a veteran, and he, at least, for whatever reason, well, you know, the Lord is Father of spirits. He's going to use the spirits the way he see fit. So, you know, this man was awake enough. He like, basically, they're going to be coming for us. He like, there's more of them, and they better armed, but, you know, we still could win. Because, you know, so basically, these Edomites are more aware than Jake. Like I said, I just told you, there's a video where a nigga, super nigga demon. I've seen rappers say some crazy shit. I've seen a number of things in my lifetime, but I've never seen that until today. I say, what the? This man had the baby. And then what type of demon can you possibly fucking be to see your baby to my aisle and crying? And what about the nigga that did put the tattoo on him? That nigga need to be killed, woke up, and killed again. Real talk. Because, and you could tell the niggas in the street, like the elder said, like, that's a lifestyle, selling drugs and whatnot. That's a religion. That's why you got motherfuckers that'll do it, like, for their whole life. You know, I know guys, I could have been one of those guys. I know guys that spent their whole life in and out of jail going back to the same piece of street. And never, you know what I mean? Like, all we did with that time is literally, like, give our life to Esau and make Esau, like we kept his, like, and call a lawyer, my Yahweh Shabbat Shah, that the Lord gave me the spirit to recognize that and get up out of that. Because, I know guys still in the world. I just seen one at camp. And he see me and I see him. And he want to come down here. But then at the same time, he didn't come down there. Super demon. I didn't see him at first, but I should have saw it because I saw his mother walk past. You know, I'm like, well, damn, you know what I mean? But she didn't look at me, but I happened to see her walking past. I seen her while she was walking past, like, at the peripheral. I happened to look, I'm like, yeah, that hurt. Mask on and all that. But, you know, when you know a person, you can see them regardless if they got a mask on or not. At least little stupid-ass hospital, man. But then, like, say, something told me to look up. The spirit told me to look up, and I look up, like, half an hour later, I see him. I said, what the? You know what I'm saying? And you know it's a heavy demon on him. You know what I mean? He's sitting over there just looking. I don't know. I don't know if he was debating or like he wanted to come and get the knowledge, or he just wanted to come and be a demon and disrupt the, you know, the church. Or I don't know. But Salaki, for the digression, it's just like, you know. And the scary part is that could have been a salvation. You know, you sit up there for whatever. Well, you know, but people got demons on them. You know what I mean? Like, at the end of the day, we understand and realize, you know, brothers, you know, spirits jump on and off of brothers. You know what I mean? That's the reason why brothers have brothers. You know, you know, to help fight these demons. And, you know what I mean? These spirits. And, you know what I mean? You know, with brotherly love. You know what I mean? You know, that's, again, one of the, I ain't going to say the main reason. I'm going to say one of the reasons to really love this brotherhood. Salakia, for digression though. It says, verse 16, for there shall be sedition among men and invading one another. They shall not regard their kings nor princes, and the course of their actions shall stand in their power. Verse 17 is the point. A man shall desire to go into a city and shall not be able. And you can see that now. You know, they already start doing this in other countries. So that's coming here. They did it in China. They done it in the UK. They doing it in Australia. You don't think they doing it here? Eventually? And then you got all these wealthy-ass Edomites. Well, not just Edomites. You got a lot of wealthy of America moving to Dubai. They think they just go move to Dubai and escape. Because Dubai already probably got, like, that's why they said Dubai is like the place for the wealthy right now. Dubai is probably already, Dubai is probably like Sweden. You know what I mean? You know, you got people with money that could just travel to Dubai and just drop down on the helicopter pad. And, you know what I mean? Go watch some. They had a video of Will Smith in fucking Dubai. And basically, it was a pool over there. And the swimming pool was made into the fucking earth. So these motherfuckers think that they go have America all fucked up. We gonna be catching hell while they kicking it. Just like the elder apostle Tahar said. He said, wow, you going to have, you know, the men of the Lord and the Israel, they're going to be catching tribulation, you know, to extent. You're going to have other people in other places actually living like day by day, like as if none of this is happening. Until the end come. I got one more scripture. You know, this is the book of, where is that at? Book of Daniel. Chapter 8, I'm going to start at verse 23. And in the latter time of their kingdom, when the transgressors are come to the full, a king of fierce countenance and understanding dark sentences shall stand up. And who is that king of fierce countenance? Well, who is these people that's an authority that's literally coming up with legislation saying you can't do this and you can't try. You got certain places that you can't go in the grocery store without showing you've been took this venom. Verse 24, his power shall be mighty, but not by his own power, because at the end of the day, the Most High, Yahweh Shem Yahushua, control. It tells you that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of man and give it to whomever he will. And he shall destroy wonderfully and shall prosper and practice and destroy the mighty and the holy people. So you already know that the time of Jacob's trouble is fastly approaching. That's why basically they trying to paint Jake as the picture of rebellion, the picture of, we the ones that contract and pass this boogeyman disease. We're more susceptible to get it. You know, it's a reason for that because he's painting a narrative. Verse 25, and through his policy also he shall cause craft to prosper in his hand. And when you go into that policy, basically it's going into the laws that they make. And they're making, like it said, it's, you know, and I can believe all this. It's a reason why they're working on these highways. I mean, because, well, contrary to what people believe, the highways wasn't set up for your dumbass to go to work. The highways were set up for the military to move, just like ancient Rome. When the last time you seen them working in a hood by the freeways and shit? I'm just starting to see this now. So these people about to move. And through his policy also he shall cause craft to prosper in his hand, and he shall magnify himself in his heart, because this devil is the proudest creature on the planet. And by peace shall he destroy many. Salaki, and by peace shall destroy many. And, you know, by peace, that's why you're going to have a lot of people who are going to be trying to take this venom to actually get life back to the way it used to be. When, in actuality, you know what I mean? Like, the world is never going back to the way it used to be. Call loyim la yabashim al shah. Because the sooner this, you know, this devil coming out with great wrath, the sooner we can get to the kingdom. You know, this place suck. I hate it here. You know what I mean? I know my life will never be, even when I was in the world, my life was never the way I imagined in the world. And now that I'm in the truth, it's, you know, everything is more surreal and more, you know, you got the truth. So, you know what I mean? Like, at the end of the day, like, it's vexing to just even, like, you know, like, this place is stuck. It sucked. You know, like Mr. Smith said, it stink. You know what I mean? Like, I got to get out of here. You know what I mean? Like, the fuck? This place, you know. It says, and through his policy also he shall cause craft to prosper in his hand, and he shall magnify himself in his heart, and by peace shall destroy many. He shall also stand up against the prince of princes. Who was that? Yahushua Mashiach. But he shall be broken without hand. You got to be prideful. You got to have an exuberant amount of pride to stand up against the Most High and our big brother Yahushua. I'm talking about you seeing chairs. You can't even understand, you trying to basically figure out the chariots. Have no idea about the chariots. You just know it's something out there. You know, some of your technology then caught glimpses of it on here and there, but you can't explain too much about it. But you still gonna be so proud that you gonna call yourself trying to fight against it. But they tell you the book of, what's that, Proverbs? It's, I think it's Proverbs 16. Let me see it. It talk about, let me see it. I think it's Proverbs 16 to 18. Yep, Proverbs 16 and 18. It say, "Pride goeth before Salakia." Proverbs 16 and 18. "Pride goeth before destruction, and a haughty spirit before a fall." And this devil, I swear, closer to the end, it tells you in the scriptures that as the judge is, so is the people. So you know this devil is like more prouder when he at his lowest. And people are like that too, because like I said, you got, well, you know, I found out something surprising, you know what I mean? Like my demon, as much as I have trouble with my demon, you know, she said some shit to me just recently, and I was like, wow, you know, I never thought I'd hear today, or see today, rather. So, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know, like, I could literally say, as proud as I know she could be, that was some very humbling, you know, but, you know, this devil, he ain't gonna get like that, and you know, a lot, of course, the truly wicked won't repent. They're not going to become humble. You know, it tells you in scripture that humiliation can come before honor. You know what I mean? Most of these people, you know what I mean? Like I said, these devils going to be still trying to talk about America great while you clearly see this bitch circling the drain. You know what I mean? Like, and that's going to be the way of a lot of these people. So again, it says, Proverbs 16 and 18, pride goeth before destruction and a haughty spirit before a fall. Let's look into the word haughty. Exalted, grandeur, hauntiness. You know, like with your Donald Trump. And your Biden. Your Biden don't even answer shit. Hey, but it's funny though, because they like, wait, humiliate Biden. He had press conferences and shit. They like, fuck Joe Biden. His place over with. So like it. So, yeah, you know, so I don't know what move they going to make that's going to, you know, well, it's going to be when they try to chip everything, you know what I mean? But, you know, they got to, you know, be circumspect and on the lookout for, you know, some false flags here and there. You know, today is the Shabbat. It's double Shabbat coming. So, you know what I mean? So, you know, at the end of the day, just, you know, prepare your spirit. In your mind, if you're so-called, you know, the brother Amawan Abad, he did a video. He said, "Gird up the loins of your mind," and rightfully so. We all need to be prepared for that. If you're so-called Black, Hispanic, Native American, Seminole, Indian, West Indian, or Haitian, I implore you to come back to the laws, to the statutes, and to the commandments of Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, or be destroyed. With that, I want to give all praises, all honor, and all glory to called Loyim, like Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, Bashim Rachakotus Bukatab. Double honors to the apostles and to the elders, the great millstone who do rule well. Peace and salutations to the Akim across the four corners of the earth, pushing this truth with faith and with sincerity, as well as risking their lives and their freedom to do so, now more so than ever. Shalom to the Akwath and the Akim out there listening and learning. Lord willingly, this is an edifying video. Shalom to the Israelite foreigners scattered abroad in the land of other nations, appearing like the other nations, subscribing to this truth. To you, I say shalom. Until next time, I'm able to come with another lesson. Shalom, shalom. And Mawath Lava Ball, Shalom.